So, Sijit, for one, I have to say I love your book. I'm still reading it and it's captivating. I'm sure there's a question on everyone's mind. How true is it? Did you send that text? And how much of this really happened?
It actually happened.
All of it's real.
It actually happened. How would I be able to use their name and write a story like that?
And what have their reactions been that you documented this?
I think it's very sporting that they agreed that I used their name, because we were toying with, you know, ideas like Ramu Shyam Sundar Sharma, and, you know, Ben something. And then I was like, no, they're my friends, I can just ask them. So that's what I said, and Ramu said, of course. I said, Ramu, read it first. Then he read it and he said, of course. So, and even Karan was very sporting, so was Nagesh.
Very sweetly, the other. Yeah, and so was Nagesh, very sporting. No, I have a lot of voice, it's fine. Nagesh was very sporting, so Ken Ghosh, and all these all incidents that happened, you know. I mean, you can't always make up things so bizarre.
And what made you write this book? Why?
I was originally asked.
Use
the
door.
And use the door, yeah.
I was originally asked to put a compilation of my blogs together by a publisher, and I agreed, and then he said, write a few new pieces and just use the rest of the book. But as I started writing, I found it developing into a whole new book. And then it's very interesting because I wrote the book, the publisher was Gango, everything was great, and then something happened, and then I called off that contract. And then for about 6 months, I was just not able to get another deal. I mean, I had friends like Amish Tripathi, and, you know, Aloka, and Farooq Ghoti. It was just me and my Indian Bombay Standard Time. Anyway, so then finally Hachette, Nandita from Hachette, who's published the book, she loved it and she took it over, and then it took on new life.
Yeah. Awesome.
Yeah. But I remember calling up Farooq Ghoti, one very despondent night, and saying, you know what, first this publisher was not going, I wanted the book so badly, and now it's like, he's like, relax, very down, just send it to me. And then he put me in touch with her.
Is there anyone whose name you had to change or you had to drop? Obviously, you can't tell us who.
The name, I've used some real names and some obviously fictionalized. And the ones that have been fictionalized have been fictionalized for a reason. So, you know. So, yeah. My favorite part of the book is still, I've read the book about 1,000 times, but the part of the book is still. Makes me cry is that the part where I'm doing the Sarigama and the Doremi and with the bandit queen and the virgin queen mask, and she comes in and my daughter comes in and I have a breakdown. That's my favorite part.
Obviously, your mother has a big part in the book.
Our mother has a big part in
the book. No, I know. How did she react to it?
My mother was very upset.
In a very traditional way, she's the main antagonist in the book.
She was very upset.
She was.
But I think, you know, we're all grown up now and we all decided, we all talked about it, and then the time came that I have like right to write my story the way I see it.
She's happy now.
I don't know about that. she's at peace with it. Happiness and peace are different words.
Who's Pankaj in the book? Come on, step back.
Who's Pankaj? Pankaj. See, all my guests are not coming. I have a lot of guests coming, arriving later on. A lot of them are not here, but when they do come, just look around and see the man who looks the guiltiest.
That's
okay.
My other heroes of my book are not here, but can I just get you with my star cast? Right now you and Kaveri and Mahavi star cast together, so just want to walk, yeah.
Ken is definitely
a good guy.